Ed Sadler, the Liberal Democrat councillor for South Oxfordshire District Council, representing the Chinner ward. Yeah, we were really surprised by the result, and it was a real pleasure to be the first district councillors that were not Conservatives. We've worked really hard to get that. It was on the back of the previous 2 years where we had won the council beforehand. So we knew we could do it with a bit of hard work, but yeah, we were very pleased with the outcome.
Hello, I'm Ali Gordon-Creed, and I was recently, as in recently in May this year, elected as a South Oxfordshire District Green councillor. I was extremely surprised. I was invited to run with the sentence, "We'd like to give people a box to tick that isn't conservative." And I thought, fine, I will give people a box to tick that I won't be elected because I'm a Green councillor in a conservative area that's never been anything other than that. And then I was. Both my running partner, Ed Sadler from the Lib Dem party, and I were elected by a considerable majority. And I would probably say two or three reasons why. When I was talking to people on doorsteps, almost everyone was a Conservative, and I had very interesting and enjoyable discussions about environment and housing and development. And also the other reason that I think that made people think was hearing somebody who cared about that, genuinely cared about their community versus a national agenda. But also, giving credit where credit's due, the Lib Dem party machine is extraordinary, is brilliant. And so, although, I mean, there were 20 votes between Ed and I think the people, the work that the Lib Dems did at a local campaign level, I probably benefited from.
Well, this is the second term the partnerships run. Our hope is to continue clearing up the mess that the Tories left us in from the previous administration. We've already dealt with some of that. We're trying to get a new housing plan put in place, which will mean that we don't have exponential growth in Chinner. And we're also trying to decarbonise leisure centres and so forth, and gradually get us to the next stage, will be to get net zero.
My personal ambitions are very local, you know, that because I'm so new, and I'm new to the whole how all of this works. What I'm really enjoying, is how much energy and cross-party agreement at a local level, as well as cross-councillor and officer agreement, both at county level and at district level, there is, to either already be on the same page or be willing to work to be on the same page with a strategic plan, a local plan, a corporate plan that embraces human needs, human well-being, social needs, both local, at a bigger impact level, as well as economic and environmental needs. You know, I came in with a wish for what I kept saying, joined up dot thinking, which was missing, that you cannot impose development without taking into account the impact of that development on the community and the environment. So, having been celebrating the appeal decision, since yesterday, since we heard, and having personally been a huge part of the process, because that is literally why I said yes to running, the impact of the imposed overdevelopment that's been happening and the incredibly negative impact that's had at local level, which on government's rules of where you can appeal on material grounds doesn't get taken into account. And that's, I think, what made the difference this time, is that it was given the enacting Rule 6 and allowing the content of the infrastructure impact to have weight, and the heroic work behind the scenes from the parish councils of Sydenham and Chinner and the local residents all together. There was no NIMBYism involved whatsoever. This was a community coming together to go, you know what, this matters. We do not want this, and we're going to show and do everything we possibly can to say we do not want this. And it was heard, and it was absolutely wonderful.
The Tories agreed to massive housing growth plans to please central government. This isn't our policy. Yes.
I imagine the members of the previous district council, looking back with hindsight, realise what a mistake it was. Because what I think that was a factor in them not being re-elected across Oxfordshire. I really do, because the impact on local communities in real terms of not having places for their children in the school where they live, not having a place where one of their children might have a place, but the next one has to be taxied off somewhere else, or people struggling to get GP appointments, people having to move house because of raw sewage in the garden. I came across that in my door knocking. The fact that there is no accountability that anyone seems to impose on the people like Thames Water, who have a statutory obligation to correct the issues, to provide the water, the supplies, etc., but who don't, because they're drowning, metaphorically. But they keep saying yes, because I guess they, I don't know why, but they are and do. And so everyone realises at a point, because everyone's impacted, that this overdevelopment is unsustainable. And that was one of the phrases that kept being used in this appeal by the developers barrister, that it, you know, this sustainable development. And I internally was going, yeah, I don't think there's a single person in this room who's not on your side who would agree that this is a sustainable development by the government's own definition. Literally, and there hasn't been a sustainable development in 10 years by the government's own definition of what sustainable development is. And that seems to have just gone by the wayside in terms of being agreed, yeah, go ahead, or appeals being overturned. And so I'm just so happy. so happy that environment now is changing. It is changing, and it's changing for many reasons, not least that no one can deny that we are entering the red zone of climate emergency. And so carrying on developing where there's flooding, where there's, you know, where there are issues that are very, very real, that have to be paid for to fixed by those very companies, is having, you know, a positive effect for negative reasons, but that's how it is.